with the dog. Really? What's her name?
Mia.
Mia?
Mia.
Leah? It's a pretty name. I'll be back.
Back yep. A little bit. I'm gonna put tape on this pole.
Gotcha.
Student pickup, sir. So be this parking lot here. There are three lines. It goes by last name.
Oh, yep. Go ahead.
Thank you, guys.
Student pickup by last name.
Thank you. Okay. No, you're all good.
I should go right over the top.
I got you. I got you. Can you hear me? Wait, hold on. I think somebody's trying to call in. Hey, what's up? Jamila? Hey. Yeah, what's up? Okay. And at the school is what? Okay. Sounds good. I think I'm about to hit right now. Okay, thank you. Oh my God. Test, you guys got me again? I just had to get on the phone with Jamila with some new info. Okay.
Sorry.
You're all good. Alrighty. You guys are all good. No, don't worry about it. More important things right now.
One foot on me right now?
No, I'm saying you guys have more important things. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, well, Adam, we've actually just learned that that gun was discharged inside the school. It did hit a window, but no injuries. That person is in custody, and right now drop-off is continuous with these parents. They have decided to end the school day early, dismiss everyone for the day, and I'm going to flip behind the camera and show you just what this pickup is looking like right now. They are doing it here in the parking lot across the street from the school, and they're doing it based on last name. So if you come over here, you can see that sign right there. So whatever your last name is, that's how they're forming those lines. And it has been an emotional reunion in this parking lot. Lots of hugs, even some tears, as this was just a very scary morning for everybody involved. If you just think about everything that's happened this year with schools, with what happened in Uvalde, is what one dad here mentioned. So a very happy ending that these kids are going to be able to get back with their parents in this parking lot right here, or their loved ones that are picking them up. But again, we're still learning more and more about how this situation unfolded. So we'll keep you updated on what we learn. Live in Fuquay-Varina, Michael Grace, WRAL News. Awesome.
We watch you on TV all the time.
Oh, really? Well, I'm sorry that Michael Green. Yeah, I was going to say, this is tough when you're in the story.
Daddy.
Yesterday,
guys freaked me out when you called me, for sure.
I know, and Among Us.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Josiah? Yes, and your parents very worried. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Would you be interested in just doing a quick interview?
Yeah.
You too?
No.
I'm interested. Oh, I want to do it.
No?
No.
I'm parked over there.
No, it's okay. I understand.
Oh my god, he was telling me that he was right behind the kid when he did it, that the kid, I think, hit the window or something.
Yep,
or something.
That's what we've heard, is the window.
And he looked at my son and grinned, and then that's when my son got up and ran. Another local kid who was in our neighborhood was on the floor above him, and he heard when it went off. I didn't know it went off.
I was going to say, I know that your wife didn't want him to do an interview, but would you be interested in anyone? Really quick? Alrighty. Yeah, there you go.
Alright, get this all on. There
you go. You can put that in your pocket, and then if you can, just kind of like put it in between one of these
That actually should work, you know. And you can just look at me, you don't even have to look at the camera. Yeah, you can just look at me, and then really quickly, if I could just get your name and then how to spell it.
My name is Gerson. It's like person, but with a G.
Okay.
Last name Ortiz. And,
You keep going.
Yeah, my son texted me. I was at work, and I thought it was a drill of some sort, and he told me, no, it's real, that he's scared, to please come. So I called my wife immediately. After I called my wife, she lives like 10 minutes away. And then I let my boss know. Then I started coming over here as quickly as I possibly could, but safely. And so he told me throughout the whole time while I was driving that the police were, they just got there, and that he can hear them. And he was sitting next to the kid, actually behind the kid, when the whole situation went down. Other than that, we're glad that proper authorities responded. And no one got hurt, most importantly. Everyone was safe.
And, you know, we kind of met on the corner, and you and I were just talking a little bit, but...
I know who you was at first.
Yeah, no, that's... Well, I'm just so curious because I have to know what that moment was like when you got to hug you. Sorry.
It was terrifying because you wouldn't think something like that could, you know, happen. And you hear about it in the news, and next thing you know, you're in the middle of the situation, and you're like, so many things are going through your mind, and... Can you get there any quicker? You know, can I get there any quicker to be at my son's side, you know, if things really have gone south? But I'm glad, and you know, I thank my creator that nothing went wrong and everyone was safe. And I just hope that this is a wake-up call to the rest of America. Like, this can happen anywhere, no matter where you're from, what neighborhood you're in. And I'm just glad today was a good day for everybody.
I'll let you go and enjoy the family time. Yes, I appreciate it again.
No problem.
It was a pleasure meeting you.
Here you go.
Thank
Take
you.
Take care, man. Happy holidays.
Thanks, you too.
They were parents of mine.
What's up, man?
What's going on?
I haven't seen you in a minute.
I know. It's been kind of like a little bit slow this week besides this.
Yeah. So you can adjust to everything, though, right?
Trying to. I don't think I ever adjust to this shift, but a little bit here and there.
Yeah.
You look nice today. You got the full...
I don't know. It's every now and then I want to put on some clothes like a reporter, and then I just want to be comfortable sometimes.
Fair. Clearly, I went with the comfortable there. You know, something like that just happens. So, Matt, I just got an interview with a dad who son is inside, had to check the things out there. He kind of just laid out what his son was telling him from the inside. He said his son was right now. like texting his son, and you know, obviously getting the shot too of what the moment was like when he got to hug him. He did not know. Yeah, I just should have asked that. I did get his name and everything, so you might be able to look him up. I'm assuming he's probably okay for the rest of the day. Yeah. No worries. I was going to say, the best place to park might be just the cabin. But I'll keep trying to get interviews with parents until you guys get here. Absolutely, I got you. All right.
You want to walk on the inside? Yeah.